Today, I know there was a lot of queries yesterday, even after the class. There were four or five major points. First, let me share those points, and I'll be covering all those points here today. First was how to deal with e-journals, right? There can be two ways. If you are paying the lump sum amount, then what happens? If you are paying not a lump sum amount, but every year, there was a query from the one institution, ki we pay every year, then what happens? Second query was, jo even IIT Bombay se bhi aaya, there are a lot of assets which we generally create out of the funds. How to manage those? Which already most of the institutions, when I was going through the annual report, you guys are doing it. That these are the assets which have been created out of project funds. Third query was, jo ma'am aapne pucha tha library books ka. Let's suppose the books have been depreciated, but they are of useful use, how to treat them? Then there was a fourth query. Sir, jo aapne pucha tha interest wala point, which I hope was miscommunication was clarified. So, apart from this, there was one more query which was generally asked from the new institutions. If we are being given temporary space, like let's say I am Rohtak is there, I am Raipur hai, jo new IITs bane hai. So what happens, let's suppose we have been given some funds and create the asset, and once the building is ready, then those assets will be transferred. Then what happens? All these queries will be handled today. Bakshi sahab, ye ek aapke liye bhi hai. Kal ek request aaya tha baad mein mere paas ki sir, some sessions are relevant to us but some are not. Like AS-13, because generally investments mainly har institutions ka do hota hai. Ek PF ka hai, ek NPS ka hai, plus mainly, largely, they are doing it in banks, FD. Plus kuch jo funds ka hota hai, those are specific fund investments. The query was ka, ye toh bahut normal hai, we are mainly interested to know about AS-11, that is foreign exchange. If some student is paying, some grant we are receiving, some assets we are creating through the foreign exchange, and how to treat them. When I was going through the annual report of some of the institutions, they are largely using that rate which is available on the date of transaction. If let's suppose I am the foreign student and I have paid in dollars, then whatever is the dollar rate on that day, we are using that. Even AS-11 bhi yehi kehta hai, spot rate. But there was a query, there was a request ki sir, pure session mein, 5 days ki workshops mein, 4 days ki workshop mein, there is nothing about AS-11. So that we can look at it. Phir ek AS-17 ke baare mein aaya tha. Sir, let's suppose if we want to show our result differently, this is from the, let's suppose, chemistry, from physics, research, workshops, consulting, then how to do that? Okay. So ye hum ek naya session plan kar sakte hain.
In respect of the use of accounting standards, nobody, I think other than 17 or 18 institute, nobody has taken care of it, nobody has given reply to me. So this foreign exchange, there are particularly few institutes like IIT, IIM, they are also getting donation. We asked in many places whether they are getting in or maintaining their donation from their alumni in foreign exchange. You can open a foreign exchange account and maintain it. I did not get any feedback from anybody. Rather, there is a tendency to hide in many places. In earlier survey, I specifically asked how many funds you are maintaining. So in few cases, some people suppressed information, some people suddenly came up with information and later on denied it like that. So if you do not, I mean, truth and fair point is coming. In your policy, if you do not play truth and fair game, so what happens? So that's why this AS-11 was not taken. AS-17, I think, related party.
Nahi, AS-17 relates to segmental reporting.
Ha, so you see, we took up, there is a reason also that, you know, the school sector is having that problem. So we also invited people from the school sectors, except one CBC representative, nobody has come. So that's why it was kept. It's not that, but you should come forthwith so that we can plan it. However, I will request the speaker, if possible, so he can make adjustment in the schedule. So he can speak on and he can talk on. Thank you, sir.
So, apart from that, there were some two or three written queries also. Ek shayad Banaras se aaya tha, to mujhe diya gaya. Even those all points I'll be covering it today in the session. Right? It will go slowly because in today's class there will be a lot of practicals. Yesterday, sir, aapne kaha tha ki annual report aapki site pe available hai. Certainly, I checked your site also today. Us pe 12-13 tak ke records hain. Agar online records available, it's very good. But that shows the transparency also. It means ki 13-14 ke records must be in progress abhi. So, I'll be, because whenever we discuss here, our purpose is not to pinpoint anything, but the purpose is ki at least we can have a uniform policy so that anywhere, if any institution is facing a problem, at least no other should face it. The target of these 4 or 5 is only that. Ki at least, maybe it may take 1 year, 2 years. And when I went back, I had a long discussion with Mr. Bakshi also. I understand it's very, very tough for any institutions right from day one to immediately change their pattern. The thing which you have been maintaining for last 10 years, 15 years, and immediately just shifting to a new part. It's not a new thing. It's just making some minute changes, some adjustments. And if you remember yesterday when I started my session, I started with a first thing that this reform has already been done in the local government level. Even they have taken at least 10 to 15 years to come at this level. But now when they have reached at this level, you won't believe it, they are raising their own funds. Take the example of Ahmedabad. Ahmedabad was the first body to come out with the municipal bonds. So there can be a possibility that in future maybe, if you have your financial statements very good, apart from the government grants, you may seek the grants from any other body also. Or kisi agar aur body se, I mean institution se loan lena hai, grant lena hai, they first always ask, show your financial results. If a financial statement is proper, as per the accounting standards, it's very easy to take any loan. If you are seeing, I'm not starting with this session. As I promised yesterday, I'll be having some chocolates. So I have it today. So today there will be a lot of calculations involved. First 10 minutes there will be some exercise for yesterday's session. AS-1. Naam yaad hai? What was the name? Chali. Kitne accounting standards se? 31 in force, issued 32. Right. So I am giving you 6 questions. Right. Take your 5 minutes. You will mark the options and anyone who comes first takes the chocolate. The morning with a sweet. Let's start. First question, second and third. All six and then we take the reply. Simple MCQs, multiple choice. First done, first slide done. Okay, I'll take it from everyone. You have 5 minutes. Sir, first ka answer is? Okay, first ka A, right? First is A, next?
2 ka C.
2 ka C. I'm not saying right or wrong. I'm not saying right or wrong. Okay, then third?
B.
Okay, fourth?
C.
Okay, fifth?
B.
Sixth?
D.
Anyone else has the different answer? Sir, please. One more option. 1A, 2B, 3B. Right, ma'am. Fifth?
D and fifth is D and sixth is also D.
Sixth is also D, okay. It means you are saying this one is wrong. Okay. Sir.
1A.
Right.
4C.
Right.
Fifth B.
Right.
B for Bombay.
B for Bombay, okay.
6D.
Okay. Anyone else has a different answer? Different. Sir.
1A.
1A.
2C.
2C.
3B.
3B.
B. B for Bombay.
B for Bombay. Very good, sir.
4C.
Right, sir.
5C.
Right, sir.
6D.
6D. Okay. Anyone else?
One more.
Sir.
1A. 2C.
Right.
3B.
Right.
4C.
Right.
5C.
Right.
6A.
6A. Okay. It is giving me a heart attack, I am telling you. Because it's not a good sign. Yes, sir. Different. Different. Different.
Yes, yes. One different.
Okay, please.
First A.
Right.
2C.
Right.
3D.
Right.
4C.
Right.
5C.
Right.
6D.
6D. Okay. Now let's compare it. Then we'll see who gets the chocolate. Chaliye, let's take one more, okay? One more option. Sorry, is it different? Is it different?
Oh, yes.
Okay, ma'am.
1C.
1C, okay. Yes, yes, please.
2D.
2D.
3D.
3.
D.
4th.
C.
C.
5C.
5C.
CD.
6D.
D.
Sir, please. Good.
1D.
Okay.
2B.
1D, 2B. Very good.
3D.
3D.
4B.
5B.
5B. 6D.
Okay, sir. To a speaker, to a teacher, to a mentor, if you give a lot of options, it's not a good sign. It's never a good sign. If we see the first rule of accounts, consistency, at least this one is. And if we see the first question was, as per AS-1, disclosure of accounting policy should form part of. People who are saying C, director report, please understand, director will only give the report when you give the financial statement and the policies. So not possible. And the D part, books of accounts, never. Books of account means journal, ledger, they're never a part of that. So they automatically are out. Sorry, sir. Abhi sir, bahut hai. Aaj to main bag bhar ke leke aaya hu. Tension mat lijiye aap. Questions bahut hai, sir. Bahut, aaj to practical karana hai mujhe. AS-6 is practical. I have to deal with all your queries. Then, second was, selection of appropriate accounting policy is not based on. Yesterday, we took an example of Anoop, if you remember, about the wife, right? Then selection has to be simple, prudence, substance over form, and materiality. Question was, selection of appropriate accounting policies not based on, right? This is wrong. Because substance over form is, when we took the example of that student, when we took the example of that higher purchase example, car loan, it means out, this one. This was the reason I have not even written the names also. I don't want, because we are here only to discuss everything. At least we can learn something and we can achieve, even a 1%, if we can achieve it, then slowly and gradually, we can reach a 50% at least. Then third was fundamental accounting assumption. This I gave you a very easy trick. CAG. And ye yahan isme going concern, consistency and accrual. So logically it goes wrong. Sir, you were right earlier. Exam ka rule hota hai, jo pehle aisa likha hai na, wo sahi hota hai. Kabhi change mat kariye apna. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 chocolates are saved. And we can give it the next session. 1, 2, 3, 4 are still there. Now next is, accounting standard in India are issued by, very good. So Bakshi Sahab, this is very, very good news. Everyone knows at least about IKAI. Fourth, everyone knows it. अच्छा ठीक है सर वो तो अब एलिमिनेट हो चुके हैं ना रिमेनिंग की बात करते हैं देन फिफ्थ How many accounting standards have been issued so far by ICAI are in force? I changed that part, right? 31, so it should be C. So logically, this goes out. Last message I have line add kar diya in force. Why I'm just sharing this? Because please understand, it's not a question of just creating some competition, nothing. Because whenever, let's suppose, a financial statement are prepared, I have been a part of the accounting also. So when the auditor comes, they generally ask these things only. Tell me from where you have taken it, what's the basis, right? At least when we know all these things, the basis become very, very clear. That confidence comes and we can reply to the auditor. Because accountant sirf ek hi bande se ghabrata hai, auditor. Aap kitna bhi apne accounts correct kar lijiye, still auditor will find even one mistake, always. Because they have some different perception, we have our different perception. Fifth was, done it. Then the last, in which of the following area different accounting policies can be adopted? Yesterday, if you remember, when we took the example of Sir about Maggie, accounting policies of different organizations can be different. The question was, how the accounting policy can be different areas. For inventory, you can have a different policy. For government grants, you can have a different policy, right? Because you will be doing it today. Anand will be taking in a session. Treatment of expenditure. So all of the above has to be there. It means we can have a policies for cost, grants, everything. I was going to your annual report. You start with always basis of accounts. Then your fixed asset, then your revenue, investment, everything. It has to be D. So let's see who is the lucky one. So finally, no tiebreaker. I was even having a tiebreaker question also. Good, sir. Please. Might be a small part, but we can have a clap for it. Chali, sir. Good. Now, to start with the major part of today's session, because today again there will be a lot of calculations. And I can guarantee in today's session, AS-6 and AS-10, you will be learning a lot of new things. Because generally, I have seen the depreciation rates we have been following is the Companies Act and Companies Act bhi purane wala, Schedule 14. Honestly, tell me how many of you have actually seen or gone to read Companies New Act 13 wala? No one. You'll be surprised to know Companies Act 2013 have scrapped all the rates. They are not even talking about the rates now. Earlier it was given in Schedule 14 of Companies Act, and that was a minimum rate. The problem which was raised yesterday by most of you is that ministry should create or provide depreciation on some assets, jiske rates, the rates for which are not being given in the Companies or the Income Tax Act. Due to this, Companies Act, due to this problem, even they know it, it is very tough for them to provide an exhaustive list of all the assets for which they can provide a depreciation rate. Very tough. No one can prepare, I'm telling you, because every organization has a different asset. That's the reason new Companies Act was very clear. They said, forget about the rate. Management knows that this is an asset. They say it's an asset. They say furniture is an asset. They say building is an asset. They say roads are the asset. Okay, agreed. Take it. You calculate your own depreciation rate. I'll be sharing this today. It means now they have only given a concept of useful life, scrap value, and a cost. Use your cost, use your scrap, use your life and calculate it. It means now you will have to calculate depreciation rate yourself. No rate will be given. It means from this year onwards, maybe next year onwards, if anyone till now was following company's act rates, and logically now you have to change it. Even a CAG auditor will say, now you can't follow the old Companies Act because it has been scrapped. Next thing, it means now we should know how to calculate also. Now we should know how to calculate even depreciation rates. Uske methods karenge. Tell me, what are the two methods generally we guys are using in our annual report? Straight line and? I'll be discussing that also. Today we'll be doing a lot of calculations. You'll be surprised. They have introduced one more method. Production unit method. Reason, especially engineering mein lagta hai. There are a lot of machines. Let's take example printer. Printer is never for number of years. This projector, I might be wrong, just correct me where I'm wrong. I'm not the technical guy. If I switch it on for 5 days continuously, without switching it off, will it run after that? It is always based on number of hours. Iske box pe likha hota, iska lens kharab ho jata hai. The lens will go blank. That's the reason when we use cameras, videos, video cameras at our home, it is always advisable to take out the batteries. Bulbs, it is always written it will last up to 60 hours, up to 70 hours. Battery is always written up to 70 hours, 80 hours. So if we charge on the basis of number of years, it's a wrong concept. If we are having, let's suppose, today IIT decides to have a continuous workshop for 2 days, no break, right? One workshop, the next workshop, and next workshop. This projector will not even take a break. It will go off. And still if you are charging a depreciation, let's say 60%, 25%, 20%, it's wrong. So usable form mein nahi hai, it should not be. Even these are the issues which we'll be discussing it. You will be surprised to know, just correct me where I'm wrong, because you guys have more experience than me in at least in your institutions. I remember my Shriram College, they have created houses for their professors. Houses ke aage they create the roads, right? They create a water treatment plant for their professors. WTP kehte hai isko hum log, right? Usme STP hota hai, sewerage treatment plant nowadays. It means these are infrastructure assets. If I am correct, Companies Act, Income Tax Act does not specifically specify the depreciation rates for roads, STPs, WTP, no. Street lights. I still remember I went to Lakshadweep for one training. In the entire Lakshadweep, there was one island there, Agathi Island. In the entire island there, they were using a solar system. Not even a single concept of other than solar. It means a street light as well. Street lights pe numbering ki. Yesterday when I went to Bombay, I was surprised to see even trees pe bhi number lage hue the. All these street lamps, lamp posts pe numbering thi. It means guaranteed there has to be some depreciation on that. You always see any road after 2 years, 3 years, it is again repaired because they have a life. But Income Tax Act mein, ye toh mujhe aata hai, kahin bhi uska depreciation ka rate nahi likha hua. Am I right or wrong? Correct me, I don't mind. You'll be surprised. There is one more document which has been issued now. Sir.
Should it be capitalized again?
Sir, what bhi padhaega? Main toh abhi se issue, whether repairing is capitalized or not, right? That will take it later. It's a capitalization expenditure or a revenue expenditure, it all depends upon the efficiency. If you take example, in Delhi, you must have heard there is an express way which has been prepared connecting Noida to Agra. That entire road has been laid down again. It is created with a cement. Even with a steel ka concept usme use hua hai. It means a new road has been created.
It may be highway, it involves huge cost and long way to go. But in an institution, there are few roads which needs to be repaired and again and again.
So I'll come to it. Revenue expenditure is that expenditure which only maintains the same level, right? If you think that due to that expenditure, some new material has been used, right, which will increase the life, let's say 12 times or 10 times or 5 times, right? So there's a very thin line between revenue and capital. I'll be sharing in today's discussion. At present, I'm just starting with the questions. Because when the questions are raised, then at least his mind starts working something. I'm not even discussing, I've not even started my presentation away. Because generally, as a faculty, I have learned when a student start thinking something, then they even create some interest. You will be surprised. Just see this. Sir, please, sir.
Which act applies for us? Is it a company act or
very good. Income tax? The point arises, which act applies? Sir, if I go by the current practice, which most of the institutions are following, some are following Companies Act, some are following Income Tax Act. As per the government financial rules, because as per you are preparing us, you should have prepared as per GFR rules. Government financial rules. Companies Act mein likha hua clearly. If any act applies to you guys and there are any separate rates given, please follow that. But if no other rates are being prescribed under your act. Sir, aap see hain, one dozen of acts mein, kya kisi bhi act mein depreciation ke bare mein likha hua hai sir?
Depreciation kuch bhi nahi likha hua hai. In fact, ये जो MHRD मिनिस्ट्री और UGC के अंतर्गत है तो करीब करीब 15 या 16 या 20 एक्ट होंगे जिसके अंतर्गत डिफरेंट यूनिवर्सिटी आते हैं. जैसे कि इलाहाबाद यूनिवर्सिटी, यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ इलाहाबाद एक्ट 2005, सिक्किम यूनिवर्सिटी इज कमिंग अंडर सेपरेट एक्ट, मिजोरम यूनिवर्सिटी इन सेपरेट एक्ट, ऑलमोस्ट सारे सेपरेट एक्ट में थे. 2009 में सेंट्रल यूनिवर्सिटी एक्ट 2009 आया जिसके अंतर्गत संभवतः 12 या 15 सेंट्रल यूनिवर्सिटी नए बने राजस्थान में, गुजरात में, बिहार, झारखंड वगैरह में. एंड एवरी एक्ट करीब करीब मिलता जुलता है लेकिन फिर भी डिफरेंस भी है, क्योंकि हमने तो 2-3 जगह हम नौकरी भी किए और डिफरेंट एक्ट को मैंने पढ़ा भी है. तो कुछ कुछ जगह वेरी भी करता है रिगार्डिंग स्टैट्यूटरी ऑफिसर्स. कहीं 6 हैं, कहीं 7 हैं, कहीं 8 हैं, कहीं एकेडमिक काउंसिल, एग्जीक्यूटिव काउंसिल, कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन अलग है, तो वेरी भी करता है. और अकाउंट्स फिनांस में मुझे जो सबसे हैरानी भी हुई और अफसोस हुआ कि अकाउंट्स फिनांस पे बहुत थोड़ा सा लिखा हुआ है, लगभग कुछ भी नहीं लिखा हुआ है. बिल्कुल अपने प्रूडेंस से आपको काम करना है और आप कंपनी एक्ट फॉलो करेंगे, इनकम टैक्स फॉलो करेंगे, क्या करेंगे, कहीं कुछ भी नहीं.
एग्रीड. दिस वॉज द रीजन सर आई आस्क सर टू रिप्लाई, बिकॉज जितना मेरा नॉलेज है, maximum acts which I have gone through, they only talk about the organizational structure. They only talk about the procedural parts of the administration. Generally, finance is always taken at the last seat. And that's the reason they believe already Companies Act to hai na. That's the reason Income Tax Act to hai, so they will follow that rate. So at present, sir, nowhere is being given that which act compulsory you should follow. Even accounting standard nowhere says, sir. Abhi main bhi AS-6 karunga. So AS-6 says commonly method are SLM and WDV. Your choice. But you have to follow that iska basis ho. Because statutory auditor, aapse sabse pehle yehi puchega, sir, ye bata do basis kya hai. Please, sir.
We are from Gurghansadas Vishwavidyalaya, Bilaspur.
Okay.
In the last four year annual account, our auditor has objected in both the act. We followed in one time, they say Income Tax Act, we followed it. Next time some other person came, they objected for the that one also. So we followed both, and both
were. What was objection?
Objection, like they were telling ki as per some rule, you have you should not follow this act. You should follow the another act.
Have you seen that?
Follow the another act. Another team is coming objecting for that.
Have
also.
You seen that rule, sir? If any auditor says as per the rules, as a person duty meri hoti hai, please show me the rules. If you are saying ki income tax is not applicable, show me the rule. If you are saying this rule is applicable, ask them. That's the best query, sir.
I'll share, they have their own logic and they object with that logic.
Follow, sir.
That's the reason we can come to the conclusion that this act has to be followed, and here around many auditions are there. So we can pass on this instruction through MHRD to CAG that this act will be followed for depreciation done. Particularly.
Of course, sir. That's the point. Sir, you have a point. Hey, sir, you won't believe it, sir. Yesterday when I was having a discussion with him, I was saying to him, there needs to be one instruction which should go from the here. Because I agree, sir, there are a lot of acts, but ultimately all are being covered under one ministry, no?
Yes, ministry of course, one. Coming under one ministry, so but act has been passed by the parliament. So act is supreme in case of all
agreed.
The universities.
Whenever law is, agreed. Whenever law is there, act is there. But when act is silent, then logically ministry can give the guidelines, follow this act.
But unfortunately, ministry is not giving guidelines on particularly finance accounts. And every finance officer or finance head, they have to do on their own prudence, whatever they like. So far, objection by the auditor is concerned. Auditor objects, but they have no solution. Because in our university also, I am from Allahabad University, they objected no depreciation has been charged. Okay? No depreciation has been charged.
I've read your...
Yes. Then I asked, okay, we will charge the depreciation, just tell me whether a straight line or written down. Plus that I don't know. Then what do you know? So whatever you like, you can do.
Yes, ma'am, please.
Yes, ma'am. So first thing, the university is exempted from payment of income tax. It's a non-profit making organization, that is one.
Then,
Yes, we follow the income tax rates within, but the depreciation rates are not the maximum rates prescribed in the income tax we are within. You see, I, as per my understanding, the rates given in the table in the Income Tax Act is for rebate when for a tax assessment. But we don't pay income tax. That is one point for sharing. And so I don't think we have to go to the maximum because see, when we have buses for students, it is not really the depreciation rates goes up to 60% if I remember correctly in that table. It can maximum can be 60% for commercial vehicles, but our vehicles are not commercial vehicles. We are not a commercial institution, so I think it's our prudence that we should not go up to that maximum. And again, there's one in the buildings, if I remember correctly, buildings of wooden bamboo, these are 100% depreciation. So the audit yesterday, when we have constructed some bamboo huts from the National Bamboo Mission, why no depreciation rate? Why no depreciation was provided on them? So since we are taking the shelter of the Income Tax Act, it says a building out of, from wooden, anything below a wooden, no? So there's no depreciation on those. They are 100%.
I agree. True. That is the reason. This is perfectly.
There is a lot of confusion if we go by the Income Tax
Act. I agree because she has put it in the right words. If you just follow, let's say, one act, sometimes just to follow one act blindly without applying the logic will create a problem for you. This is the reason that Companies Act has removed the rates. And trust me, day is not far behind. Let an Income Tax Act get revised. Direct tax code is about to come. Even they will also remove or at least give the standard rates and apply the logics. Because Companies Act has given a very good logic, use your useful life, use the cost and calculate the rate yourself. Sir.
You just explained the concept of the depreciation which have come recently, that useful life and scrap value and the cost of the item. It may be building or furniture. But point is that Whether it will be universal in all cases, because some of the institutes will be located in coastal areas where corrosion value will be more. So there can be an institution where units are located, headquartered Delhi or Mumbai, and some centers located in Port Blair or Lakshadweep, etc. So there the useful life will vary. In that situation, the organization will be permitted to have different kind of depreciation rates within the same organization.
I'll show you. Even this point I have included in my presentation. Reliance, one company charges four different depreciation rates for different units. It has to be.
This is a very valid question, because Bilkul. Many of the organizations having units at different locations.
Bilkul, you are right.
Useful life will certainly vary from place to place.
100% it will vary, 100%.
And when we'll compile and when we'll incorporate all those units accounts in main account, the rates, I don't know how to reflect the rates, because they are presently you are writing that rate is common for all the units in the accounts. Now how to reflect those differential rates in annual account?
It will be very tough to write all the rates. You have to just write, I'll just give it, okay.
Yeah, I have started noting down your suggestions. Few suggestions yesterday I have received. One, there should be one software for all. Then uniform accounting policy. Then uniform depreciation rate. Then another suggestion came, whether they should engage CAs. Then somebody says, a letter from CAG should come. And then another suggestion came, regional workshops. So already I have started noting down your sentiments. But we come forward, give all your suggestions. But some of them we can work on, many of them we may not task at all. Like depreciation, we may not task it at all. Because of your autonomy and divergent requirement, no IAM will follow, if I say you follow WDM. They, many of them you are following a straight line method. So everybody has their own logic. Then we cannot also prescribe uniform accounting policy.
One thing can be decided. Mainly we have two accepted depreciation policy methods, straight line and written down. It can be decided by the ministry whether to follow this one or that one. So far as I think, no institution in India will have any objection in it to following either a straight line or written down.
They will be welcoming it, at least have a once.
Or at least, or isse sir kya, nahin sir, isse hoga kya? कि सारे हिंदुस्तान में एक यूनिफॉर्मिटी आएगी और किसी इंस्टीट्यूशन को कोई आपत्ति नहीं होगी, जहां तक मेरा डिस्कशन अदर मेरे फेलो मेंबर से हुए हैं. आई एम आल्सो हेडिंग फाइनेंस
रूल कंपैरेबिलिटी.
और इसमें क्या होगा, ऐसा
जो एसएलएम फॉलो करेगा उसका प्रॉफिट अलग आएगा, जो डब्ल्यूडी करेगा प्रॉफिट अलग आएगा.
बख्शी साहब, ऐसा है कि एक पॉलिसी आप जब मिनिस्ट्री से डिसाइड कर देंगे तो हमें बहुत ज़्यादा दिमाग लगाने की जरूरत होगी नहीं. इंस्टीट्यूशंस में बहुत ज़्यादा सोचने वाले लोग वैसे हैं नहीं. हर जगह हम लोगों को माइंड अप्लाई करने नहीं दीजिए. कुछ जगह जहां इजीली आप डिसीजन ले सकते हैं, यू टेक द डिसीजन, जस्ट इशू ए सर्कुलर, जस्ट विल फॉलो. एसेट्स चाहे जिस प्रकार के हों इंडिया में, चाहे नागालैंड में हो, चाहे इलाहाबाद में.
रेट्स नहीं हो सकते हैं?
नहीं, रेट्स तो वेरी डिफिकल्ट ऑफकोर्स. नया आप जो कर रहे थे नए कंपनी एक्ट में रेट को डिसाइड करने के लिए, मैनेजमेंट पे छोड़ दिया है.
I'll come to it अभी.
सर, अभी जो लास्ट ईयर हमारे यहाँ जो ऑडिट हुआ है, इन द सेम प्रॉब्लम वाज देयर बिकॉज दैट टाइम डिजास्टर वाज इन उत्तराखंड. तो उनका ये कहना था, विच एवर पॉलिसी यू आर फॉलोइंग, गेट इट अप्रूव फ्रॉम योर बोर्ड एंड फाइनेंस कमेटी, एंड वी हैव डन दैट, एंड इन दिस फाइनेंशियल ईयर वी आर अप्लाइंग.
विच ईयर यू आर डूइंग?
बेसिकली as per our requirement and as per our location and we follow both income tax and company tax, but we prepared a separate items.
Aapka Uttarakhand ka hai?
Yes sir.
Take the example, let's say here. I'll take a, why the rates are not possible, ma'am? If, let's suppose they have to prepare the balance sheet and the income expenditure for the last year when there was a cyclone.
Yes,
sir. So logically, maximum assets have taken a lot of erosions, you can say, or a depreciation. So still, if you think no, I'll still apply SLM 10%. I am seeing that computer has almost destroyed. Still, if you're applying 10% SLM, because the law says, law always says the minimum rates. Income tax rates are to be given just to claim the income rebates. Nothing else.
Sir,
I agree. Sir, that's the reason I'm saying rates cannot be predefined. Rates cannot be predefined.
And sir, our statutes and acts also permit that whatever policy you are following, get it approved from BOJ.
They are very simple. Even, see, in my last 13 years, I have met a lot of auditors. They never say, they always go by the papers. If it is been approved with some rules, they allow it. Sir.
The point is that what I asked, whether within the same organization differential rates can
be. Bilkul, sir,
and,
I should.
And this will be a challenging area for the software which is being prepared.
Bilkul hoga.
Because if differential rates are there, compilation of account at the headquarters will
tough
be
hai. Another. What, see, another law never stops you. Tough hai. Law doesn't stop you. To simplify, please don't take it otherwise. Just to simplify our work, we say, okay, let's go by only one rate.
Some of the organizations under MHRD are having single units, but many of the organizations are having multiple units located in different parts of the country. If they start following differential rates, that will be a real challenge in compilation of accounts.
Sir, challenge hoga, but just starting 1-2 saal, 1 or 2 years. Bilkul hoga, you're right.
Sir, can we come to the consensus over here for WDM and SLM at least? It's a major difference in that. If we come, at least for this house, we can have them one consensus.
We'll take it. We'll take it after the presentation gets over. Because there are a lot of new points, I'm telling you, there are a lot of new points. Lot of new points.
Sir, my request is government is organization charge the depreciation only show the true and fair value of the asset.
Right.
Not getting any benefit from the charging depreciation from the income tax. So
right.
Only the issue showing the true and fair value, it is better government of India say either these or these only for the purpose of satisfaction of the auditor. Ki why
right.
You are charging this method, why you are charging this method.
Right.
Otherwise, in my opinion, no any benefit from charging depreciation to government organization.
For the scrap value, we can purchase the new machinery after the scrap of that machinery. The reason is
creating a fund from the depreciation.
We can purchase.
Why purchase? You are creating fund from the government
sir,
grant.
Depreciation.
I think government not permit to maintain any depreciation fund.
See, depreciation mein, see, sinking fund method is very different. Sinking fund is given, but not as per the income tax. But still you are following it.
Sir, as per my experience, the rate of depreciation has to be approved by the board of governors of the respective organization.
Yes.
And prior to that, their finance committee. So it is not necessary that every organization has to follow the same rates. It depends on the organization to organization. And I also served 4 organizations, and there are different rates in all the 4 organizations. At present, I am working in the NITI. NITI rates are different, and previously I was working in TIFR Kolaba. So TIFR was having different rates. So it has to be approved by the respective BOG. And their ministry will definitely will not object for that, because the financial advisor is part of the BOG member. So it is not essential that every autonomous body has to same rates.
Sir,
that is my experience.
See, rates, even ministry will not be able to give you the uniform rates. Because let's suppose they are giving the rates, take the example of here, every organization has different units, different assets. Rates cannot be given a list, but at least a method can be given. The major, there are two requests from everyone. First, a letter to a CNAG, right? And second is, let's suppose any clarity about the depreciation. So let's proceed. These two requests, only two requests.
Rate of depreciation would be finalized by Board of Governor or Executive Council whatsoever. तो अकाउंट्स फाइनल करने का तो समय आ गया रेट हमारा अप्रूव नहीं है तो अभी फाइनल में क्या डिप्रिसिएशन लेंगे हम व्हिच वी आर गोइंग टू फॉर 13-14
यू आर एन ऑटोनॉमस बॉडी ऑल टू
एक्सेप्ट आस्क गाइड नहीं सर प्रेस करने तो वो सर रेट ही हमें नहीं पता है व्हाट टू चार्ज द डिप्रिसिएशन
रेट ही पता है इसी रेट पे काम चलाएंगे बट दिस यार ओवर देयर इज अ कंफ्यूजन नो द वन रेट एंड द वन द न्यू
सर इन्होंने अभी तक लगाया नहीं है इन्होंने रिक्वेस्ट दी थी 150 करोड़ का दिस वाज अ रीजन बिफोर आई स्टार्टेड दिस आई हैव क्रिएटेड सम क्वेश्चंस Now at least we can look about the points about AS. Your point, different rates, right? Your point about the methods, your point whether we can apply the depreciation if we have not provided in last 20 years. There was a query from one of the institutions, without naming anyone, that we have not charged depreciation for last 20-30 years. And if today we charge the depreciation, then the total amount is more than 150 crores. Should we charge it? If we charge it, then our income expenditure doesn't show surplus. It should deficit. How to deal with such points? All such queries are being covered here.